Ah, I see the queen has taken well to her new home.
It's fascinating. She has already started to spawn. Incredible, really, that we found such a healthy specimen.
How long until we can expect to see interspecies polymorphism?
We should be patient and allow the colony to grow first. I've placed food nearby. Then we will introduce the Formica fusca and observe their reaction.
Excellent. Keep me updated on their progress. I think it is time we connected the outworld to the feeder colonies. I want to see how these eruptors respond under pressure.
I will prepare the experiment.
Let's begin with a small threat.
Connecting the Fusca colony now. I will let 10 through to start with.
Thank you.
The queen is in danger. Perhaps I should stop the experiment.
What is going on? What happened to the queen?
The ants were...
This Formica Fusca queen has set up home beneath a rotting log. She is fat and vulnerable. Her first brood will need to move quickly if the colony is to survive. Their priority now is to find food, and there is plenty around. But there are other hungry creatures down here. The workers will need to be vigilant. The ants have encountered a pocket of woodworm. These defenseless weevil larvae will make an excellent meal for the colony. They will be butchered and carried off for processing. The workers have uncovered carnivorous larvae of Ochipus olens, the devil's coach horse. They are born ready for combat, with powerful slicing mandibles for chopping up their prey. They are still small, however, and must undergo a final pupation before their armor is fully developed. If the ants are fast, they should be able to overwhelm these critters. If the ants had disturbed the adult of these larvae, the outcome for the colony may not have been so fortunate. They must expand with caution. This colony must remain small for now. Food is too scarce to support greater numbers. workers have done all they can to prepare this brood chamber. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. The queen is in imminent danger. There are intruders in the nest. This colony must remain small for now. Food is too scarce to support greater numbers. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. The ants must protect the queen. The colony is starving. There is not enough food to feed the new brood. These wood lice will make a significant addition to the colony's larders, but they are clinging tightly to the ground. It's going to take some effort to dislodge them. There are intruders in the nest. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected.
Thank you.
This colony must remain small for now. Food is too scarce to support greater numbers. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. The workers have done all they can to prepare this brood chamber. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. This colony must remain small for now. Food is too scarce to support greater numbers. There are intruders in the nest. There are intruders in the nest. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. The ants have stumbled into the path of a fully developed devil's coach horse beetle, and it's hungry for breakfast. The beetle is almost 4 times the size of a black ant and protected by thick plates of external armor. Whilst it bites at the tiny defenders, it sprays foul-smelling secretions from the end of its raised abdomen, disorientating the ants. The devil's coach horse is dead. Its corpse will provide food to support dozens of new brood. There are intruders in the nest. The colony is starving. There is not enough food to feed the new brood. The queen is in imminent danger. The the workers have done all they can to prepare this brood chamber. The ants must protect the queen. This Formica Fusca colony has now established itself as a rising power in the undergrowth. Soon their territory will need to expand above ground, where new challenges await. For the time being, however, the Queen is safe.